Mafia 2 Definitive Edition. We're going in. We're on a motherfucking mission. Continue story. This would be part 2, I think. I keep dropping like dominoes. The formidable, abominable, stomping. I'm not holding my copy even if it's off the top. Chapter 3. Enemy of the State, Joe's apartment. February 10th, 1945. Answer the phone.
Joe's pleasure, pal. It's Vito speaking.
Vito, why didn't you come home last night? I was worried sick.
Mama? I didn't know you had Joe's number. And whose phone is this?
So have you spoken to Mr. Pappalardo? Find yourself a job?
Yeah, he told me to come by and see him today. Hopefully he's got some work for me.
Okay, Vito. Good luck, mio bambino.
All right, bye, Mama.
Pappalardo. Pappalardo. What am I looking for?
It feels weird to me so many times how many people still have their parents.
Yeah. Or their grandparents, too.
Or the grandparents.
Yeah.
Just the grandparents.
Open the door. Oh, change my clothes. Okay. Who's Ed?
Oh, hi there.
What's the matter? Nothing good on the radio?
Mind your beeswax, kid.
Nothing good on the radio? Huh. Nothing up here.
If you don't turn that crap down, I'm gonna call the cops!
You better knock it off, man.
If you don't turn that crap down, I'm gonna call the cops!
Does he just keep repeating himself? Jeez. It's the Sherbert pervert. Oh, damn. Take that one. Not really. It's just fast. Gave me a trophy.
Maybe I didn't go fast enough. Achievement. Papalado. Papalado.
Oh! Close the door. It's windy. What do you want?
Yeah, I'm looking for a Mr. Papalado.
Oh, yeah?
Why?
My name's Vito Scaletta. My old man used to work for him, and I'm looking for a job, so I came here.
Well, you're in the right spot, sonny boy. Federico Papalado at your service. You can call me Derek. I think I remember your dad. Good guy, but drank like a fish. What's he up to these days?
He's dead.
Oh, well, y'all gotta go sometime. Right, Steve?
Sure, Derek.
So you need a job, huh? Well, you're in luck. We just got a new shipment to unload. Steve will show you around. Now scram, my steak's getting cold.
Follow me.
Okay, this is gonna be bad. Nope. No boobies on that one. So I won't get a copyright thing or get in trouble for showing nudity on YouTube. I just have to be really quick when I pick them up. Pick them up and close them as quick as I can.
Load this pile of crates onto that truck. When you're done, you get $10. If something gets lost or broken, you get nothing. Start now and don't take all day.
That's bullshit, man. Load all these crates. Leave when I've had enough. I'm done.
Hey, you done?
Yeah, I'm done. And you can keep the $10. When I said I needed a job, I didn't mean slave labor.
Whatever. Get the fuck out of here, then. Don't show your face around here again.
Yeah, don't worry. I can make 100 times more working for Barbaro Incorporated.
Wait, you said Barbaro? Joe Barbaro?
Yeah, so what?
Shit. Nobody who works with Joe would carry crates for $10. What the hell are you doing? Come with me.
What now?
Well, this one don't like manual labor.
What the fuck?
Said he works with Joe Barbaro.
Bullshit. Who wanna load crates if he works with Joe? You'll have to explain this one to me, sonny boy. What's your story?
My mother wanted me to come talk to you about an honest job, but I need some real money, so this ain't gonna cut it.
Them women, they're all the same. Right, Steve?
Sure, Derek.
She doesn't want you hanging around with Joe, right? My mother was the same way. Look what become of me. Union boss. I got the whole fucking waterfront under my thumb. So how's Joe?
Pretty good, I guess.
How'd you meet up with him?
Oh, we go way back to the old neighborhood. I just come back from overseas and he's putting me up until I can get back on my feet.
Listen, you gotta understand, a person in my position has gotta be careful.
Certainly.
So you won't mind if I give Joe a call, right?
Nah, go ahead.
Now, where'd I put his number? Hey, here it is. He might not be home. That wouldn't be good. Hi, Joe. Hey, this is Derek. Listen, I got this guy here. What'd you say your name was?
Vito.
Vito. He's looking for a job. He says he's a friend of yours. A good friend. I just wanted to check with you first. Uh-huh. Sure. War hero and all that shit. All right. Thanks, then. I'll talk to you later. Sorry, pal. I had to check you out. Joe says you just come back from Italy. You must be able to handle yourself. You want to make a little more money? I got just the thing. The guys here at the port are supposed to pay a monthly fee to the barber, but half of them never cough it up. I need someone to give them a little nudge. $10 a man.
What if they don't need a haircut?
Well, then you'll have to convince them otherwise.
I see. What if somebody makes a fuss?
Then you kick the shit out of them.
Well, let's say you teach them a lesson that doesn't require that they miss work. You got it? Which is why Steve ain't doing the job. Right, Steve?
Right, boss.
Collect at least $150, I give you 50. Just for walking around, taking in the Sierra, meeting new people. Easy fucking money, eh? What do you say?
Yeah, hey, it's better than lugging crates around.
All right, then. Get going.
Yeah, something.
I'm here to collect the fee for the barber.
Hey, what kind of game you playing here?
The kind where you pay what you owe when you don't get hurt. You got a problem with that?
I got a problem with you. Now get out of here before I kick your ass. Here's your fucking money.
Yeah, glad you decided to reconsider. Oh, yeah, I got this guy already. Hey, pal. Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Yeah. I must have forgot or something.
Next time, try to pay on time, okay? Thanks. Hey, Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Sure, here it is. I don't want no problems.
Don't leave it until the last minute next time. Hey, pal. Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
He's Paul.
Look, asshole. I'm not in the mood. Why don't you get out of my face before you get hurt?
Ah, no can do, pal. Derek wants his money.
Derek can kiss my ass. What's that fat fuck gonna do? Have me killed?
Hey, you said it, not me.
Why don't you give it a try then, asshole?
Tear him a new one!
Okay. Anybody else got a fucking problem with paying for the fucking barber? Here's the money, boss man.
Good job. Here's your share. I watched you take care of Bill. You were good. Steve damn near got his ass kicked when he tried that. Right, Steve?
Right, Derek.
Here's a bonus for sorting him out.
Thanks.
The guy's been a real fucking pain. Now get out of here, kid. I gotta be getting back to business. Say hello to your mother for me. Tell her you got yourself a job as my new assistant.
Yeah, will do. I'll see you later.
And Vito, I almost forgot. Joe called. He wants you should meet him at Freddy's.
How you doing?
The jukebox.
Hey, where the hell you been?
I came right over as soon as you called. What's going on?
You remember the wise guys we used to see when we was kids?
Yeah, why?
The guy we're meeting here is one of them. His name's Henry Tomasino. I think he's got something big for us.
Yeah, no shit.
Yeah. We're done with the small-time jobs. It's time to make some real shuttle. Here, he's coming. Don't say nothing stupid.
Hey, Henry, how are you?
Hi, Joe. This the guy?
Yeah, this is Vito, an old friend of mine.
Good to meet you, Henry.
You vouch for him?
Absolutely, Henry. Trust him with my life.
Okay, listen, I got a job for you. The money's good. I need gas stamps. They're worth a fortune now because of the gas shortage.
Where can we get them?
In the Office of Price Administration.
That's a federal government agency. Isn't that a little risky?
What? Too much for you?
No. Just trying to think of how we can pull it off.
It can't be that hard. The stamps are kept in the safe at night, but the keys are probably around here somewhere.
You got somebody inside?
Yeah, one of our guys. His sister works there.
Can she help us out?
Ask her yourself. Her name's Maria Agnello. Here's the address. Tell her I sent you.
All right, what about the safe? What if the keys aren't there?
That's your problem.
But what's the job pay?
I'll give you 600 bucks for 10,000 gallons worth of stamps.
Okay, we're in.
No, no, I need Vito to do this alone. I got another job for you, Joe.
So, what do you say, Vito?
Yeah, sure.
Hey, and don't forget to take a piece with you. You never know what's gonna happen. Better to be safe than sorry. I got beef.
Wait. This isn't some liquor store stick-up. I want this to be a clean job. If you kill anybody, your cut drops to a third. Gabish?
Yeah, I got it. No problem.
Okay, when you're done, you come back in, we'll settle up.
All right, I'll see
you. Good luck, Vito.
Yeah, so long, buddy.
Yeah, can I help you?
Yeah, hello, ma'am. Henry Tomasino sent me. He said you might be able to help me with a little problem down at the Office of Rice Administration.
Yeah, I heard about that. What do you need from me?
I need to get in there tonight.
All right, tell you what. My sister's in the hospital right now. If you give me a lift over there, I'll tell you everything you need to know. It's right across the street from the OPA, so it ain't like you're gonna be going out of your way.
Sure, no problem.
Let's go. And take it easy behind the wheel, all right? I seen the way you kids drive these days. All right, kid. The place is locked up pretty tight at night, so you gotta get into the back.
They keep the back door open at night?
No, but the basement window usually is, so that's how you can get in. You're looking for the safe, right?
Yeah, how'd you know?
Lucky guess. It's on the top floor. So's the director's office. That's where the keys are.
Okay. So I go in through a window around the back, then head upstairs to the director's office, right?
Right. And be careful, there's guards in there at night. Don't let them see you. Hey, Leadfoot, take it easy. My sister ain't going nowhere. Drop me at the hospital right here. The office is across the street. Okay, thanks for the ride, kid.
Thanks, Maria. I'll see you.
Mm-hmm. that when I see it. I pipe down while I finish my puzzle.
Ah, raspberries. I'm gonna go make the rounds.
Good riddance to you.
Weekend.
Yeah, want to relax and watch me some television.
You bought a television?
I sure did.
Man, those things cost as much as a car. How the hell did you afford it?
Mary's Uncle Lou passed away a few months back, left us some cash.
You bought yourself a television with it.
Okay. This is the director's office. This is where the key should be. All right, here's the key. Now I gotta get to the safe.
Well, how'd you make out?
Things got out of hand. There's nothing I could do about it.
We had an agreement. Remember? You only get a third of the money if there's any shooting.
Let's see what we got here. Ah, shit.
Something wrong?
You bet your ass there's something wrong. These stamps you took have an expiration date. And that date is tomorrow.
So, what exactly does that mean?
It means they're gonna be fucking worthless. But wait. If you can get them to the gas station attendants by midnight, they'll be able to stamp them and redeem them. You better bring them to every gas station in town. They gotta get there by midnight or we're screwed. If you don't sell them in time, you get nothing.
Wait a minute, that wasn't our deal. You didn't say anything about any expiration dates.
Well, shit happens, doesn't it? Look, you pull this off, I won't forget it, trust me. Now get going. The faster you unload them, the more money you get.
Okay. Better hurry.
Yeah, so long, buddy.
I would take a wealth and Wall Street for a road when nature tries. Then I calculate that I have worked my way in gold and rust.
Hey, you in the market for some surplus gas stamps?
Sure. Where'd you get them? On second thought, I don't even want to know.
Smart man. All right, now fork over the dough.
Yeah, all right. Just hope I don't get in trouble for this.
Don't worry about it. Just keep your mouth shut. Got some extra gas stamps. Interested?
Yeah, sure. I'm interested.
All right, here you go. Fork over the dough.
Sure. Here's your money.
Thanks, pal. Now forget your song. Got some extra gas stamps. Interested?
Yeah, sure. I'm interested.
All right, here you go. Fork over the dough.
Sure. Here's your money.
Thanks, pal. Now forget your song.
What the
Hey, interested in buying some gas stamps?
Sure. Just keep this between you and me, all right?
No problem. Just make sure you do the same.
Sure. Sounds good to me.
Buying some gas stamps.
Sure. Just keep this between you and me, all right?
No problem. Just make sure you do the same.
Sure. Sounds good to me.
Listen, I got these extra gas stamps. You want them, they're yours. Cheap.
Yeah, all right. I'm good with that.
All right, here you go. And keep your mouth shut about this, all right?
Sure thing, buddy. It'll be our secret.
It better be. All right, that's the last of them. At least I got some cash. I should head back to Joe's.
Let's bamboozle where gals keep using those silks and satins and linens that shows. I'm all yours and buttons and bows.
Silks and satins and linens that shows. And I'm all yours and buttons and bows.
Give me Eastern trimming where women are women and high silk hose and peekaboo clothes and French perfume that rocks the room. And I'm all yours and buttons and bows.
In pursuit of a speeding vehicle. 10-4. Some idiot just drove into us. We're bringing him in. Roger that.
Almost 1,000 B-17 flying fortresses blanketed the capital of the Third Reich with
Jeez.
Look at this. Didn't know Joe could even write.
We got another job. Something really big. Stop by Freddy's tonight. Bring a piece and some lockpicks. Who's here? Where the hell you been? Laying around in bed all day?
Hey, I'm entitled to a little rest after that last job, don't you think?
What can I get you, sir?
Coffee.
Just for now. And when Alberto hears about this, the shit is gonna hit the fan. Believe you me.
So, I heard you didn't score too big last night.
Well, it wasn't exactly my fault. Shit happens.
All right, come on, relax, fellas. It's a high-risk business. If you don't like it, you can always go break your back working for peanuts down at the docks.
Sorry, Henry, I was just breaking balls, you know. So how about tonight? We still on for what we talked about yesterday?
We'll see in a minute.
That is too fucking much, too fucking many. I want my money!
What? You think I'm running some kind of fucking charity here? Do it. Now!
Who was that?
Somebody you don't need to know right now. All right, listen up. There's a guy who owes the boss some money. He borrowed it to open some big jewelry store. He's not paying it back fast enough. We're gonna collect his payment tonight. In jewels. Plus, a little extra for our trouble. Joe, fill him in.
The jewelry store's in the shopping mall in the middle of town. There's no guards at night. So all we gotta do is pick the lock and waltz right in.
Sounds a little too simple.
Because it is simple. Why's everything gotta be so fucking complicated with you?
Says the guy who can barely change a light
bulb. Look, don't worry. I thought of everything. I got these phone company uniforms so we can pretend to be fixing something.
Fair enough. Let's go.
All right. We're gonna rob this fuck blind. All we gotta do is wait until dark. Hey, so how'd it go with the port?
What, you mean with Derek?
Yeah, he's a piece of work, ain't he? Give you a job?
Yeah. That works some guys off. But it was small-time crap. He shakes down these hard-up dock workers just like he did my old man.
Well, you didn't have to do it. It's not like he forced you to work for him, is it?
My mother almost did.
Quit whining and keep in touch with Derek. Trust me. He's got better jobs than shaking down wharf rats. What do you got, an aversion to red lights?
Sing, sing, sing the victory polka.
Raise your voices loud. Stop.
What is this, the Indianapolis Speedway?
Take it easy, I'm in a rush.
When the boys have, I'll come on to stay.
And the million bands begin to play.
We'll be dancing the...
What the hell is this?
Come on, boys. The cops will be here any minute. Move it!
Ryan fucking O'Neill?
What the fuck is this?
You crazy bastard, what the fuck are you doing?
Barbaro, what the hell are you doing here, you fuck?
You're a little late, Chief. There's nothing left here for
fuck
you.
Fuck off, Fatso. This is our heist. You want to get out of here in one piece, you better hand over everything you've got.
Well, the sign outside didn't say Brian O'Neill's place. If it did, I wouldn't have robbed it. Instead, I would have set it on fire.
Reported at the West Side Mall. Repeat, 1031. Burglary
this
in progress. This
is car 54. We're on it.
And I suggest you get lost before the cops show up.
Ah, fuck!
Kiss my
ass.
Get the
fuck out of here.
Get the fuck out of here!
What the hell are you waiting for? Get him, lads!
Brian, what about the cops?
Come on! Let's get out of here!
I'm trying!
Shit! Cops! Wipe my ass while I open his door. Keep those assholes off my back! Almost got it. Hold on, just a little longer. Come on, you piece of shit, open up. Okay, got it. We're out of here. Vito, come on.
Freeze! Police! There's no way out!
Another dead end. We gotta go this way. It's our only shot. Come on, Vito, move your ass.
Fucking crazy. It's covered in ice. One slip and we're dead.
We got no choice. I ain't going to the joint. Get your ass over here. You waiting for a formal fucking invitation?
Over there! Shoot!
Shit! Jesus, be careful. I almost lost you there.
Yeah. I think I just shit myself.
Where'd they go?
They must have gone this way, Sarge. Oh, fuck that. I don't get paid enough for this.
This way. This should take us to the street. Shit! Cops!
Freeze! Police! There's no way out!
Almost got it. Hold them off just a little longer. Okay, got it. We're out of here. Vito, come on. Henry's never gonna believe this. Stupid bastards. Let's go.
Who the hell was that?
Brian O'Neill. Crazy Mick bastard. Not too bright. Usually works his hired muscle.
Yeah, I didn't think he was the brains of the operation.
Shit, the cops. Come on, get out of the light. Let's go. Come on, come on, come on.
Don't worry. Give me a bag. I'll go ditch the goods. All right, pal. Meet you back home. Try not to get pinched on the way there.
Killed.
I think you'll find the quality is well worth the price.
This just in, the West Side Mall has been rocked by violence as Empire Bay Police were involved.
All units, code green, back to the station.
Will that be all?
The criminals have been arrested, but nothing more is known at this time. More news on the story as we receive it. Now, let's get back to our regular programming.
Enjoy your.
situation is mighty queer, like the Yankee girl, the native swoon. When she hears the bingo croon, drinking rum and coca-cola, put down point Kumana, both mother and daughter, working for the Yankee dollar. Out on Manzanella Beach, G.I. romance with native peach. All night long make tropic love, next day sit in hot sun and cool off, drinking rum and Coca-Cola. Go down Point Kumana, both mother and daughter, working for the Yankee dollar. Rum and Coca-Cola. Working for the Yankee dollar.
Easy.
Hey there, handsome.
Hi there.
Joe ain't here right now. He said for you to meet him for lunch at Freddy's.
I see.
Too bad you were passed out when I came in. We could have partied. Maybe next time, doll. Bye.
Huh. That was something.
Okay, I'm gonna call that an episode.